We started with this method of observable design, which was called Kremser method. Last time we started with this, and this method is used or has some advantage as compared to the previous method, which was graphical method. So in this method, here we mentioned number of advantage, and one of those was when you have to design an equipment the purpose is to absorb multi components. So in that case, this was helpful as well. The other major advantage of this method was that when temperature and pressure are not constant throughout the column, then equilibrium line will not be at one position. It will be varying because equilibrium line depends on temperature and pressure, K values. And if temperature and pressure are changing, K value will be changing, and then definitely position of equilibrium line will be changing. So in those cases, this method was helpful. So last time we derived some equation in which we considered the absorber, and through that absorber we said that if the component which you want to absorb is only entering with the gas stream from the bottom of the column, and we considered that the solvent or the liquid which enters from the top was pure. So today here we have to discuss such cases in which any component which you want to absorb, that is part of gas as well as if it is part of the liquid. So in those cases, what you have to do or how to handle those things, or how your equation will change as compared to the previous cases. So here you can see few diagrams in which actually there are shown three schemes, and those schemes include actually the recovery of the liquid or a solvent which you are using to remove some component, to absorb some component from the gas. Actually, in each of these, there is one column which is absorber. For example, in the A's, you can see here there is an absorber, and then the other column is stripper. As we discussed earlier somewhere, that most of the time there will be absorber and stripper, and they are installed together, and the purpose is that the liquid which you are using for absorption of various gaseous component, that liquid should be recovered or reclaimed inside the stripper, and in that stripper, after reclaiming it, we bring it back to the absorber, and by this we save the liquid cost. If suppose that liquid cannot be recovered, cannot be regenerated, cannot be recycled, then each time you have to bring new absorbent. And I already told you that this is not 100% recovered, or its amount is not sufficient. At each cycle, you have to make some makeup. You have to add some additional amount to meet the requirement of the process. For example, here if you need 10 liter, just for example, and at the end of the day when you have absorbed something, it goes to the stripper, some of its amount is stripped out from here and some other losses can take place. So due to this, for example, its amount is 9 pound or 9 kg per hour here, then you have to bring it back. It should be 10 here inside column. So due to this, we will do the makeup of 1 kg or 1 pound or so on. So this, in this case, when it is shown absorber and stripper, in the next diagram also you can see the absorber and stripper. But in both of these diagrams, there is a small difference between the stripper, as also we studied this somewhere earlier, that stripper section can operate on different principles, or that can involve different mechanisms. The mechanism, for example, here to strip the components which are absorbed inside liquid is to use some stripping vapor or steam or some inert gas. We already studied this, that we can use steam, air, or some inert gases to strip the components from the liquid which are commonly used. So in this, here we are just using a mass like separating agent, some stripping vapor, and that removes the component. In the other case, here you are not bringing something from outside. There is no stripping vapor or steam entering here. But what you do, this is called reboil stripper. In this, we have a reboiler at the bottom of the column, and here we will take some liquid from this. It goes to the reboiler, and some part of this liquid which is entering from this column, stripping column, to the reboiler, some part is vaporized, which are usually the lighter components. In this, they can be those components which were absorbed inside the absorber, as well as some part of this liquid can be vaporized, and then that enters through this column, and when these vapor move towards the top, they act as a stripping media. And then the other part of which is recovered as a liquid from this reboiler, it goes back to the absorption column. So this reboiler is similar one which you have seen with the distillation column. Here its main symbol is not that proper one which you usually use for the reboiler, because in reboiler, when this stream is entering, it is just separated into two. How it takes place, hopefully you know the kettle type reboiler, or just look at that diagram, or maybe you are just studying these things in process heat transfer. Hope you will come across proper diagram there how this separation is taking place. And the other case can be there when you absorb something inside the liquid, and maybe it is not possible to easily separate it with the help of some stripping vapor or this adding reboiler. In those cases, even distillation can be used to recover the solvent and then bring it back to the column of absorber, because this is recycled or reused. So in any of these cases, whatever we are using to recover the solvent, to reclaim the solvent, or to recycle the solvent, when we have to remove the component which were absorbed inside the liquid, inside absorber column, this the purpose of liquid was to absorb some of the component from the gas, and inside the stripper or next distillation, the purpose is to remove those components from the liquid which were absorbed earlier, so that liquid can be reclaimed as a pure liquid. But when you look at the systems inside, like industries, overall, none of these systems completely remove the components from the liquid stream. So here, stripping action is not perfect actually. The recycled absorbent contains some species of those components which are actually part of the vapor stream, but they are also coming with the liquid stream. The thing which when we derived the equation in the last lecture, we considered the liquid which is entering from the top of absorber column is pure, but that is not pure. Actually, that contains some species, and those species are those which are actually part of the vapor stream which you want to absorb, but some will be coming with the this liquid, because liquid was not perfectly regenerated. Some of those will be still there, in maybe in very small amount, but still they will be there. So in those cases, when those species are the part of liquid stream, so when they will come in contact with the vapor or gas stream inside the absorber, although from this gas or vapor stream we want to absorb some of the components, but at the same time, that vapor or gas act as a stripping agent. This act as a stripping media for that liquid component, or which is part of the liquid component. And when it will be acting as a stripping media, that gas can remove some part of that component from the liquid and will take it with itself to the top of the tower. So in those cases, when we are just doing so, so how our equation which we just wrote last time, they will change, or how the balance when we applied on the equipment, they will change. So based on all this discussion which I have done with you, I have told you that this liquid which is recycled, that is not perfectly recovered inside the stripper, and if it contain some of the components inside this, and those components, for example, you were using heavy oil to remove butane and pentane from the gas stream. So actually, this gas stream which is entering from the bottom, that contain, for example, butane. And we want to remove that butane from the gas stream. We want to absorb it inside the liquid. But if that butane is also part of this liquid, because in the first cycle, when fresh liquid passed through this, that absorbed some of the butane and it went to the stripper, but inside the stripper all of the butane was not removed from this liquid, so liquid will come here and will contain some amount of butane. So in that case, this butane which is coming here, that species which I just named it here, for example, butane, so when this butane, which is part of the liquid, will come in contact with this gas, so gas will actually try to strip that butane molecules from the liquid stream. So in that case, when it is entering from the top and it is stripped, so its amount will definitely reduce here inside the liquid. So overall, in such cases when there will be butane inside the liquid as well as inside the vapor stream, later on it will become part of the vapor stream leaving from the top as well as part of the liquid stream leaving from the bottom. So we can apply a balance of that component on this system, and this balance equation is the same which we applied last time, that if we consider complete column and inside that column if any component is entering from the top as well as from the bottom and leaving in the vapor stream from the top and leaving in the liquid stream from the bottom, then its equation can be written as like L naught plus V n plus 1 is equal to V1 plus Ln. This is equation same which we already used for overall balance on a absorber column in last lecture. So here it will involve same equation. And if you remember from that lecture, in the previous lecture, we usually used to just remove this L naught is equal to zero because we considered there that liquid was pure. But here we will not make it zero. It will stay as such because in this case here it is part of this stream. So in this specific case, overall this I wrote the balance that when it is part of both liquid stream and vapor stream, though I will solve it later on in the next case, but in this specific case here after this we considered that, for example, this component which was butane, if it is only entering from the tops, from it is part of the liquid stream, it is entering only from the top of the column, in that case here its amount in vapor is considered as zero. Just we have to derive some equation for that. We are just taking this simple step, but in next case again I will bring it back. We will not make it zero. Just for example, consider here that inside absorber this is entering and that contains some component which is only part of the liquid stream, and if it is not part of vapor stream, definitely this inlet value will become zero. And when we make it zero, then we can write that that equation will be modified like L naught is equal to V1 plus Ln. So already you also know from the previous lecture that concentration of this component in liquid stream at bottom, when going with this Ln, this can be calculated by using another equation, and that equation was Ln is equal to L naught into phi s. And this is why I am writing this in terms of phi s or stripping, because any component we said that which will be entering with the liquid stream from the top, that will be stripped away with the help of this stream of gases which is entering from the bottom. Although this specific component is not of the gas stream, but gas stream can contain other components, so in this case so that liquid part will be stripped away. And if we want to see that, if for example 10 kg of this or 10 pound of this enter from the top, how much is remaining at the bottom when liquid is leaving, so that can be contained or that can be found with the help of equation. And this we also have seen that time that for stripping action this equation can be written, that amount of that component in the liquid stream leaving from the bottom inside this absorber column will be equal to its initial amount multiplied by phi s, and phi s is fraction, not strip. Definitely, for example, as I said, it is 10 here and at the end it leaves as a 5. So it's mean 50% has already been stripped. So that if we want to find, and we know the initial, like what was its initial amount. So that is like initially if it is 10 and 50% is not stripped, so that will become part of the bottom stream. And this equation already from the previous lecture, hopefully you have revised that and know about it. So we can put this value of Ln in the equation which was written on the previous page. So there was here L naught is equal to V1 plus Ln. So just put its value and you will get it. The equation will be L naught is equal to V1 plus L naught phi s. We will just rearrange this equation and we try to find the value of V1. V1 is amount of that species which is going to the top of the column in the vapor stream. So that can be found by using, if we know its initial amount inside the liquid stream, and if we know that how much it was stripped, fraction of the strip, because phi s is fraction not stripped, so 1 minus phi s is fraction stripped. If it was part of the liquid stream and was stripped inside the absorber column by the action of gas. So this equation can help us to provide our concentration of that species which is only part of the liquid stream and is being stripped, then your equation will be this. But let's come back to that case from where we started, that if it is part of both entering from the top as well as from the bottom, then if we want to find its amount, that how much of that amount will be going to the top of the column V1, then we can find it. Actually, if we are only looking for this, that how much of that species is going to the top of column which is V1, we can find that amount of species inside the vapor stream. Look, anything which is already part of both liquid and vapor stream, for example, there was butane, and if butane was coming to both liquid and vapor, so in that case, now if butane is going to the top of tower and it is coming here as a part of V1, so it will be contributed actually from the both liquid stream as well as from the vapor stream. Inside the vapor, if it is, the purpose is to absorb that, maximum definitely will be absorbed, but some part of this will be going to the top of tower. So it's mean amount of species which is not absorbed from the gaseous stream, and other amount which will be contributed toward this butane going to the gaseous stream at the top of tower, some can be coming from this because it is also part of this stream of liquid. Liquid is not pure in this case. So amount of species stripped from the liquid. So we just derived equation for this, that if we have to calculate amount of species stripped from the liquid inside absorber column, that was L naught into 1 minus phi s plus amount of species not absorbed, that can be calculated by from the previous lecture. You know that anything which will be going to top, V1 was equal to Vn plus 1 multiplied by phi a, and phi a was something fraction of species not absorbed. If I just multiply fraction of species not absorbed with the initial amount which was entering to the column, so in that case it will give me amount of species going to the top inside the vapor or with the vapor stream. So this equation will help you in this case. If you know this equation, you can just simplify it. For example, we say that this equation is to use to calculate the amount of any species in vapor stream going to the top of column, and if it is only part of vapor stream, then when it is only part of vapor stream, it will not be part of liquid stream and this will become zero, L naught will become zero. So when it becomes zero, so in that case, when it is zero, equation is simplified, as you have already seen, that V1 is equal to Vn plus 1 into phi a from the last lecture, that if it is only part of vapor stream. But just consider, okay, if we want to see its amount and it is only part of the liquid stream, it is not part of vapor stream, maybe there will be, when you will be solving the problems, there will be some component which are only part of the liquid stream, they are not part of any vapor stream. So in that case, they here Vn plus 1 will become 0, so automatically equation is reduced to V1 is equal to L0 into 1 minus phi s. Hopefully today at the end we have to look at the problem and we will be using these equations here. The other case is for stripper. Similarly, in stripper we say that any component which is absorbed inside the liquid, we want to remove it, and that component should be part of the liquid stream which is entering from the top. But here in this specific case, we consider that if that liquid stream is entering that contain any species, which is coming through this column, which we want to remove from liquid. It will be stripped out from the liquid, but at the same time, if that species is also part of the stripping media, which is entering from the bottom, or stripping gas, or stripping steam, that is entering from the bottom, and if that is also part of this, then how you have to calculate amount of that species in the liquid stream leaving from the bottom, because here the purpose is to get the pure liquid stream, as the purpose here was to get the pure vapor stream, pure gas stream, which does not contain any impurity. But if any impurity is going with it to the top of the column, here we wrote its formula and we discussed it. Similarly, for stripper, actually your purpose is to derive or to look for some equation which gives you the amount of impurities still part of the liquid stream, which we have recovered the liquid, we have recycled here, but if anything is still part of this, how to find it. So in that case, we can again also write that amount of species in liquid stream. Here it will be coming from two streams, one from the liquid. Originally it is part of this, it should be there, but at the same time, if it is part of the vapor stream, so we will say that amount of species which is not stripped from the liquid, here the purpose was to strip it completely, but if it is not stripped completely, it will be coming here. That how we can calculate, and for that we already know from again from the previous lecture, this was that L1 is equal to Ln plus 1 into phi s. Ln plus 1, its initial amount entering from the top of column, and phi s indicates that fraction of the species not stripped inside this. So here it will be plus V naught into 1 minus pi a. This is amount of species absorbed from vapor stream. Here the opposite to absorber will take place. The purpose of this gas stream is to strip the components from the liquid stream, but some parts of that vapor stream will be absorbed inside the liquid. So when those are absorbed, how to calculate them? That can be calculated with the help of V naught, its initial amount coming with the vapor stream, or coming with this stripping stream, multiplied by its amount which is absorbed. 1 minus pi a is the amount or fraction which is absorbed, and if we will multiply with the initial amount, it will give us the amount of species absorbed. And if you write the simple V naught into phi a, phi a is species not absorbed, so it will give you V naught multiplied by phi a will give you value of species not absorbed. But here we are looking for the species which is absorbed, so it will be V naught into 1 minus pi a. So to summarize all this, that whenever your either liquid stream which is entering to the absorber is not pure, that contains some of the impurities as well, the vapor in the case of stripper, if that contains some amount of impurities, so in those cases, if you are concerned, if you want to find the amount of, in case of absorber, the amount of that specific component going with the vapor stream, that will be calculated with the equation I have already shown you, that from where it comes, or I wrote complete equation for this, that is that component from the liquid side as well as from the vapor side, which is like not absorbed going to the top, as well some component which is stripped from the liquid. And this is from the previous lecture, in which we just considered that this L naught is zero, so in that case this part becomes zero and this equation is simply reduced to this form which already we know. So in case of stripper, similarly we just saw the equation that if we want to look at the amount of that impurity, that how much it is leaving from the bottom of distillation, stripping column, so that can be found by two contributing part. One is definitely from the liquid which is not stripped, but the other is something which is absorbed from the vapor species. So guys, these are two equations, 6.35 and 6.36 from your textbook, which you will be using a lot while you just solve the problems, because you have to find a lot of amounts. And in those cases, as already mentioned, that you can just simplify these equations. Actually, these equations show that when the component which you are concerned is part of both liquid and vapor stream entering to either absorber, or here in case of stripper. But if that is part of only one stream, the other will become zero. Either, for example, in this case, this become zero V naught, or in case of absorber, usually this become zero if you are bringing here pure stripping media or here pure liquid. But if that is not pure, that contains something, then it will stay here. So let's apply this equation somewhere. But before that, because up to here, what we have discussed in this method, initially in the previous part of the lecture, we discussed that how to calculate number of trays for any system which is involving the absorption, or maybe for stripping, you can use that method and we derive some equations. And further, we have just extended those equations, those balance, if we have to calculate the amounts of the components. So here we will look at two examples. In both of these, we will try to just apply these concepts or these equations which we have discussed. So in this example 6.2, this is the similar one which you have already solved by using graphical method, actually, in example 6.1. So we are going to use now the Kremser method to calculate So calculate number of trays, because in this question the purpose was to calculate number of trays, and previously we did it with the help of graphical method, but in this case we will use Kremser method and I think a few other calculations which we have to do. So what is given to you here, that recovery of ethyl alcohol from CO2 stream is carried out by absorption in water. Assuming the absorber operates at 30 degrees C and 110 kilopascal, these were conditioned for that. The total entering gas flow rate was 180 kmol per hour and with 2% methanol. In that, 2% is methanol and 98% is CO2. So absorbent is pure water. So in this case, there was like absorbent is pure water which is entering to the system. The specified recovery of ethanol was 97%, already it was the same, and it's mean 97% ethanol is absorbed and 3% will become still part of the vapor stream. K value for ethanol is 0.57, we have already calculated, so I just took it from there. Assuming an entering absorbent flow rate of 2 times the minimum, determine the following using Kremser method. Here in this, it is mentioned that you have to consider 2 times the minimum absorbent flow rate. If you remember, at that time we calculated the minimum liquid flow rate, L minimum, and then we just took it at that time as a 2 times. By the way, book has they followed already 1.5 times in the previous example 6.1, so they are again using here 1.5. But we solved the problem already with 2 times the minimum absorbent, so we will use again here the same, so that we can compare actually the number of rays which we calculated earlier with this method. So we have to use Kremser method and find the number of equilibrium stages or the plates or trays required for this separation. The second part is the fraction of the entering water stripped into the gas. Guys, liquid or pure water is entering from the top, and purpose of that water is to absorb the gaseous species, which is ethanol coming with the gas stream and leak from the bottom. So if you remember, last time we considered that any liquid which is entering from the top, it leaves as such from the bottom, as well as gaseous stream, which is CO2, which is just entering from the bottom, it leaves exactly the same amount from the top while we were solving or using the method which was graphical. But here he asked us to find the fraction of entering water stripped into the gas. This is something which is entering from the top, but it can be stripped with the gas inside the absorber. Somehow gas will try to trap some molecule of the water, will take them away with itself. So we have to calculate that. And here P set at 30 degrees is 4.24 for the water. So the third part is fraction of entering CO2 absorbed by the water. Your purpose here is to actually absorb ethanol from the gas stream, but some part of the CO2 can also be absorbed, which you have to calculate here. And this already I have provided the data by after looking at the specific diagram in fourth chapter. We will need Henry constant h bar CO2. So that is its value is given here either 918 or 1918 or 195 k kilopascal. So this you can look at this or later when you are solving the problem in the fourth and second chapter, such kind of data is available which you can see. So okay, now we have to solve this problem by using Kremser method. Earlier we solved by using graphical method. So in the Kremser method, if okay, before I proceed, I'll draw that diagram, the similar one which was we already used. So that vapor stream is its amount and its what is the composition and what other values were given. I have just mentioned that in the diagram. So here data is given that it was 180 and out of that 98% CO2, so that is 176 kilomole. If we just look specifically at CO2, that is 176. And C2H4, ethanol entering from bottom is 3.6 kilomole. And as he mentioned that 97% is absorbed, that will become part of the liquid stream, and this was 3.492. And what will go to the top is 0.108 kilomole. And K value is given also. Already we have done these calculation actually when we solved the example 6.1. So that was liquid minimum flow rate was also calculated at that time. And then here we can just proceed. This was also done at the same time that the actual liquid flow rate is 2 times the minimum liquid flow rate. So overall liquid flow rate is 195 kilomole per hour. You have this data up to here. Now you have to do the calculations by using Kremser method. So another thing here in Kremser method is phi a we call fraction which is not absorbed. Our purpose is to absorb ethanol from this. So you know that 97% of ethanol is absorbed and 3% is not absorbed. So phi a is fraction not absorbed, so 3% can be written in the fraction as 0.03. that I have also written because we will need it somewhere. So let's now up to here data is written and you can solve the equation or to find the number of trays. What is procedure? You know that in order to find number of trays by using Kremser method, we have two methods. One is to use one figure which was 6.15. already shown you last time that diagram, and then otherwise we can use some equation, and that equation was actually called Kremser equation. And I told you that by using this same equation which is given here, actually diagram 6.15 is drawn based on the data by this equation. So if you look at this equation, either you want to use it or if you want to use that diagram, you need two parameters. If you remember, on x-axis there was AE and on y-axis there was phi A. So in that case, when you need those phi A and AE, so if you have those, there were number of lines and here were written some number which we called them number of trays, for example 3, 4, 1, 2 and up to 30 they were given. So in order to find either by using this equation or diagram, you need two values. One is phi A and other is A, our effective absorption factor. So phi A, we have this value already written at the top of this page. We know this, but now the second is we need to find AE. A simple was equal to L over KV, and here A effective is the same thing, formula remains same, but that will involve actually complete liquid flow rate entering from the top and complete vapor stream. If you remember this AE, that was combination of number of A's they were getting multiplied. They were A1, A2, up to so on, AN. And if you remember those A1, A2, A3, and up to AN, they were taken, or we just derived those by applying the balance on certain parts of the column. Always we try to reduce one plate when we were solving those equations. So when you will write AE, that means that you have to take total amount of the liquid entering from the top and total amount of the vapor entering from the bottom. In that case, you will be covering whole column. Otherwise, if this is not the case, then if you remember that when we applied balance from plate 1 to n minus 1 or 1 to n minus 2, then we said that liquid coming from that specific plate or liquid coming from the top or somewhere, so that amount can be a bit different if you are looking for some individual A's, and they make up finally AE. So this is simple L over KV. And liquid flow rate we have just calculated from the minimum one, and vapor flow rate, complete total vapor flow rate, it is not for only CO2, so that you know, as well as K value already know, so AE can be found as 1.9. so phi A is already 0.03, so you can go to the diagram. I will show you at the end of the lecture. I didn't open the book at the moment. Let's move forward. So later we will see that how you can find the number of trays. We will just actually look at on the diagram AE and phi A, and for example, if AE is on x-axis, we will try to locate its value and we'll go to the top. Phi A was at the x-axis and AE was on y-axis in the diagram. AE, because it's that fraction which is not absorbed. So here fraction which is not absorbed is 0.03. So we will look at its value in the diagram and we'll draw a vertical line. And for phi A, on the other side, AE, effective absorption factor, for that value is 1.9. We will look at that and we'll also move in this direction, horizontal line. So where they will intersect, then we will look either they are intersecting on specific line or above or below that. So when I drawn those in the book, there in that diagram, I saw that there can be 4.5 trays, but you know that we can't have it like a fraction, so we will make it next, that is 5. So this is the part one, in which that is pretty straightforward, in which you were supposed to find two values and then just find with the diagram. Other method is to just, if you put these values phi A and AE in this equation and you solve it. This is nonlinear equation and maybe you will need some solver. If you can solve it, it's fine. Otherwise, better to use the diagram to find it. But you can try with that, any solver like maybe Excel or maybe inside some other MATLAB or so on. You can find also the value of them. So B part is to find, we have to find fraction of water stripped into the gas, although we suppose that water which is entering from the top totally goes to the bottom, but in reality it doesn't happen. I told you that that is the ideal case. Some amount of the water will be just stripped with gas inside the absorber column. So in that case, if we have to find that value, we can use the equation that was for equation of stripping. That how much something is stripped. So because he asks us to find the fraction of water stripped into the gas, in order to find that, we can use that equation which was fraction not stripped. Phi S is actually fraction not stripped. If we can find this fraction not stripped, then just take its difference with the one and you can find the value. So its equation was SE minus 1 over SE power n plus 1, SE stripping factor, effective stripping factor. So already from the part one, you know number of trays or number of plates. If we can find SE somehow, then you can use this equation and will find phi S, and when you get phi S, 1 minus phi S will give you the water divided not stripped. So SE was equal to KV over L. So it is the same one already also discussed, that this reciprocal of the absorption factor. So in case of absorption factor, that is equal to A is equal to L over KV. In case of this, it is KV over L. K, this K, now you don't have to use that K of which you have already used. That was for ethanol. We were looking for the absorption of ethanol. And in this case, when we use this K is specifically for the ethanol. We have already calculated this previously in previous lecture. But here you are solving it for the water. So it means this K value is the K value of water. Vapor and liquid amount remain same throughout the column, so that we will be using same as such. So for K value, we can find the K value of water by using simple Raoult's law, because this is as we said, 100% pure what is entering, and that is pure component entering in the 100% amount, so that can be just found by using directly Raoult's law. So that those things already told you somewhere you have to use Henry law for example gases dilute system. For dilute system in the liquid modified Raoult's law. So here Raoult's law. So that is P set over P actually. Total pressure you know of the system was 110, and P set this was also given to you. Already have seen and then mentioned that at 30 degrees what is P set of water in kilopascal, it is 4.24. This will be the K value, so you can use now because already you know vapor and liquid flow rate. Put it here and find SE. When you have found SE, I think you can now solve this part because you know number of trays as well as value of SE. Just put in the equation and find this is value of 0.9961. This is fraction of the species not stripped. But you are asked to find the fraction of water stripped into the gas. So that then you will take because overall fraction is 1. So not stripped, 1 minus not stripped will give you fraction of the water which is stripped, and that is 0.0035. If you just multiply this fraction with the amount of water complete which is entering from the top of the column, which was 195 kmol, you will get how much moles or kmol of water were stripped. If you, someone asks you instead of fraction, if they ask you to find amount of water which is stripped, so then after finding it, just multiply it with the overall flow rate. So that will give you the value of that water. Okay, the next thing which is we were supposed to find is fraction of CO2 absorbed by the water. So in order to find something fraction of CO2 absorbed by the water, we have to use absorption equation, and this equation give you the fraction of some species not absorbed, and that is equal to AE minus 1 over AE power N plus 1 minus 1. Again, in this equation, we know N, but we don't know A for this CO2. So that you can find L over KV. Again, the difference here is you have to find K value. So K value for this system will be found by using Henry's law, and that is Henry constant over P. So we know that already have seen from the data from post chapter, just kindly verify it later on. So it is 195,000 kilopascal over 110 kilopascal. And if you solve it, you will get this value, 1772 K value for this system. Put it in the equation and you will get K effective absorption factor for CO2. So just put it in the equation here, fraction of species not absorbed, and you will get that its 0.994 fraction is not absorbed. And because we are supposed to find fraction of CO2 absorbed, so in that case it will be 1 minus 0.994. And it gives you 0.006 as a value of fraction which is not absorbed inside the liquid, actually very small amount of this. And if you again multiply it with its original value of the flow rate, you will get that how much it is absorbed inside the liquid. Its flow rate of CO2 is exactly 176, so just multiply with that and you will get the amount. So that is how we are using, or we are going to calculate the things by using Crimson method. Next example, that is related to usage of this equation. And now in the previous equation, we saw that there was only one component, ethanol, which we want to absorb. But if you remember, the one of advantage of Crimson method was used for number of component. If you are absorbing number of component, then how you have to use it. So in this example, actually you are going to experience that thing, that if there are number of component, then how it is going to be used. So in the provided figure on next page, I will show you high molecular weight components, normal butane and normal pentane in the hydrocarbon gas are removed by absorption at 400 psia. This is the pressure, and you are bringing some gas inside the column of absorption column, and you want to remove actually butane and pentane. So if we quickly look at that, here is the diagram. Here you can see that there is some gaseous stream entering from the bottom of the column, and that contain number of species, but the purpose is to remove actually butane and propane. So let's read the next statement. and our pressure is 400 psi. With a high molecular weight hydrocarbon oil, you already know that heavy oil can be used to absorb lighter hydrocarbon. So heavy oil is being used to remove these C4 and C5. That is equivalent to normal decay. He has told its equivalency to, like, in terms of if you want to see molecular weight or so on. So that's equal to decay. So trace amounts of each component appear in the entering oil. What does this mean? It means that those components which you want to remove, which are C4 and C5, they are also appearing in the liquid stream from the top of the column. Estimate the exit vapor and liquid flow rates. You have to estimate the exit vapor and liquid flow rate and composition via Kremser method. By using Kremser method, actually we are supposed to find amount of each component which are and going to the vapor as well as the component which are going to the liquid stream. Using estimated component absorption and stripping factor from the entering values of L and V, they are given, liquid and vapor stream. Flow rates overall, they are given with the component K values estimated with a process simulator. I have given you these values of K. He used the S1 to calculate the values of K for these component and was directly provided. So we can use that, but I will advise you just go through this in the book. He mentioned something related to chapter 2 and some equation that can also be used by hand calculation of K value for these hydrocarbons. At the average temperature, based on average entering temperature, again here actually in this problem he has covered number of parameter which help us to solve some problem by using Kremser method. First is when there are more than one component being absorbed. The second is when that component is part of both liquid and vapor stream, because here he said you want to absorb from vapor but they are also part of liquid stream. The third thing here, temperature is actually different for liquid and vapor stream. Before this all problem which you have solved, you considered that liquid and vapor temperature are equal when they are entering to the column, but here they are different. So due to this, he took the average to find the K values, but pressure remains constant throughout the column. Suppose if pressure is also different, then you have to take average for that also. So this is the diagram in which you can see that the leak stream which is entering from the top, here its composition is given or amount are given. Major is the oil and other are butane and pentane. While from the bottom, these C5 are entering in the various amounts and overall flow rate here is 800 and from the top it is 165. For each individual component, we will represent this flow rate with L0 of, for example, C4, L0 of C5 and L0 of oil. And here this is because this is stream which enters from the bottom after n, we call it n+1. So here it will be n is 6, because here in the question diagram it is mentioned that there are 6 trays. So this will be considered as the 7th from where liquid vapor stream is entering. Due to this, you can see here V small and 7, like amount of component entering from the 7th strip, 7th plate or after 6th plate, that is 7th plate. So their amounts individual are given and then their sum total V capital as well as their L0 capital total flow rate is given. Temperature of liquid entering is 90 degree Fahrenheit, for vapor it is 105. Due to this, he said that they are different and you have to take like average. But what we are supposed to find is their amounts in liquid and vapor. These are the K values already calculated and given to you. We have to use it somewhere next. So again, I have drawn the diagram. I have explained to you what is given and what you are supposed to find. So let's solve this in order to find these compositions. I will quickly go through the steps, but later kindly complete the solution. So to find the flow rates of each species when at the bottom of the column as well as at the top of the column. So because this is absorber, and for absorber we already studied that if some component is part of both liquid and vapor stream, or either if it is not, but we can write the general equation for finding that, that is V1 is equal to L0 into 1 minus phi S plus Vn plus 1 into phi A. This is from where we started today. that if suppose that species is not part of vapor stream, so it will become zero and the equation is just first part. But if it is part of both, then this is the equation. And if you are looking for some component and that is not entering with the liquid stream, if you want to find its amount in the vapor stream at the end of the day and it is not part of the liquid stream, then it will become zero. So this is the equation which actually you will be using to find the amount of vapor streams going to the top of column here. And later on, when you have find this amount of vapor stream, we already know each component entering from here, also know each component entering from vapor stream from the bottom. So we can apply balance on each of the component and can find the value of each component going to the liquid stream. But before applying that balance, we also don't know the values of vapor streams going to the top, and this is absorber. For that, we will be using this equation which we just discussed today. So in order to use this equation, guys, you can see that here you are supposed to find phi s and phi a. And for example, I am applying balance on one of the component. Then in order to solve that balance, you will need phi a and phi s for each of the component, because you know that phi s is fraction of species not stripped and fraction of species not absorbed. So this will vary, this will be different for each of the component. Due to this, we will need this phi a and phi s for each of the component. And for finding phi a and phi s, you know these equations from the Kremser method, that what does they equal to. So if you want to find, for example, for methane, I consider at the moment C1. So if I want to find phi a, that how much it is absorbed, because that is not part of the top stream entering from the top. So methane is not entering from the top, it will become zero, but at least my equation will be this, that V1 is equal to Vn plus 1 into phi a. And in order to find phi a, I will need a. Now the purpose is to find ae here. As well, if you something is part of both, so definitely you will need also stripping factor here. So in order to find this, we also need SE. So number of trays, you know already they are 6, so that is fine, but we need to find something phi A and phi S. In order to find those, AE and SE are needed, so their formula is AE is equal to L over KV and SE is equal to KV over L. So now if I write it for each of the component, I will need liquid flow rate and vapor flow rate. This is overall flow rate. And you know that that is given, it is 800 for the vapor and 165 for the liquid. This will remain same for each of the component. The thing which vary is K value. So for each of component, this K value will be varying. And that we already know that is also given. So that's mean no issue. We can easily find AE, SE, and then phi a and phi s, and when you will get these, then you will come back to this equation and can find the value of vapors, that component in vapor stream. So here I didn't do the calculation, but just wrote all of the component which are entering either from the top or bottom of the column. So they are C1, C2 up to C5 entering from the bottom, and from the top there was entering C4, C5 and oil. Their K values were given. Based on all the previous discussion, I told you that first step, although we started with this equation, in order to solve this equation, you need phi A and phi S, and then to get those phi A and phi S, we need A and S. But due to this, when I made this table, I have mentioned here that for each of the component, we need A value, AE. So anything, A is for anything which is absorbed. So all those components which are entering in the gas stream, they will be absorbed in some amount. Maybe some will be absorbed more, some will be absorbed less. For example, the major purpose is to absorb C4 and C5. So they should be absorbed in higher amount as compared to other, but they will be absorbed somehow. So due to this, we will calculate absorption factor for each of the component. Yes, I said no. We will not calculate, put cross here. The reason is because this is not part of the vapor stream. It will definitely not be absorbed. This is actually absorbent. For stripping, anything which is part of the liquid stream that can be stripped, And that is the, if you look at the diagram, there are only three components which is part of the liquid stream. They are oil, C4 and C5. It means when we are looking for the stripping factor, that will be only calculated for three components, C4, C5 and oil. So this here when we write A and S, so this is done for only three component and A is calculated for five component, because they are part of the liquid vapor stream, they will be absorbed, and they are part of the vapor stream, they can be stripped, maybe in large amount, maybe in small amount, but they will be. So due to this you have to find SE. When you have found A and SE, definitely by using the equation of phi A and phi S, you can find the values of these. And when you are done with this, now you are in that shape that you can use this equation, which was equation 1, to find the value of any component going to the vapor stream. So that, for example, here I said that if I wanna do calculation for C1, so for C1 that component was entering only in the gaseous stream, so V1 of C1 component, then similarly you will calculate V1, mean amount of C1 component going to the top, then amount of C2 component going to the top of the column in gaseous stream. V1 is for something going with a gaseous stream. So that equation 1 which initially we wrote, that will be simplified here in case of methane or C1, because it is not entering from top of the column, its L0 value is 0. So that is only Vn plus 1 into phi A. Vn plus 1, its amount entering from the bottom of the column in the gaseous stream, that you know that it is 160 here. So I will take this 160 multiply by phi A. And phi A, when we have calculated here, we can use it and we will find the value of C1 going to the top. Similarly, you will keep on doing for all of the component. This will be calculated V1 for 5 component, which are C1 up to C5. And as well, you will find for oil, because there will be some part of oil which will be stripped, that will be going to the top. But for oil, when you will write the equation, this equation, this part will become zero, because for oil, this is not part of vapor stream. It is only part of liquid stream, so this part will be dominant only. So when you are done with all the V1 values, as already told you, that now you can apply the material balance on any of the component and can find its value going to the bottom of the column in the liquid stream. So when you apply overall balance on any component, so that is L0 plus V7, mean its amounts entering to the tower from top and bottom, and its amounts leaving from the tower. So just we can rearrange that equation, because we are looking for L1 of any one component, L0 plus V7 minus V1. You know if its amount entering from the top, entering from the bottom in the vapor stream, and then its amount leaving from the top, which you have calculated in the previous step, you will be easily finding those components. So kindly do these calculations and complete this. I will also advise you, there is a 6.4, kindly go through that. If you have any issue, you can discuss with me later. So that's also, based on same principles, same equation. So guys, thank you so much. Okay, now you can ask me.